Hi, my name is John. Have you ever considered that the highest elevation trade you can have done at your home is tree work? But how does a homeowner know whether a company is using safe tree practices? In this video, I want to share some tree knowledge so you can identify basics of safe, professional, and responsible tree work. Before I jump into that, please hit the like button. It is our human instinct that gravity and high elevations can be dangerous. Some of the most iconic pictures of the American industrial age are of iron workers walking untethered while skyscrapers were being built in Chicago or New York. I see my emotional reaction to this come up as a granddad when either of my two toddler grandchildren get near stairs. If you've ever watched a toddler tumble over a step, you know why. Gravity is high risk. As a parent or grandparent, you try to teach your toddlers to grow in their skills. But when dealing with stairs and gravity, it needs to be approached with a safe methodology. Tree work is similar. Despite the inherent dangers of gravity and high elevations, tree work can be safe with proper methodology and practices. You can watch videos of removal of trees on YouTube. It's an interesting watch, but have you ever noticed how few of them emphasize safe work practices? In fact, it's almost the opposite of that. With the sheer kinetic energy involved in tree work and the potential for property damage and personal injury, a practical, safe approach to tree work is prudent. We had a project with a mature Leland cypress that needed to be removed due to an excessive lean. Here's some of the safe work practices we use. Number one, a safety meeting. Reviewing the site to avoid inherent dangers. Best industry practices recommend it, and in the state of Washington, it is required by the Department of Labor and Industries. Many times, the crew will also use this time to stretch to avoid personal muscle strain injuries. Number two, safety chocks. Equipment being stable during operations is important. Number three, personal protective equipment. This is one that's easily identifiable. This includes safety glasses, hearing protection, and a helmet. This would also include chaps and boots, which could also be Kevlar pants and Kevlar boots. Number four, climbing gear inspected. We all have faith in something. Professional tree climbers have faith in their ropes. Both the ropes and climbing harness should be inspected daily. There are other more technical safety items, but these items are a minimum safety list. If tree work is done without these basic items, you can assume that other industry safety protocols are not being done as well. Safe tree work can also be fun and entertaining to watch. Occasionally in our work, we get to use our work to create a lasting memory for young children. Our project provided an opportunity to take our safe work environment and have that extended to Eli, the 8-year-old son of our client. Before removing the tree, we used the moment to create a memory. We threw him a ball off the top of the mature Leland cypress, the foundation of what created the environment for being able to create this fun memory was safe work practices. There have been studies done that indicate that when you are 7 or 8 years old, you have a higher retention of memories than almost any other age of your childhood. That's a parenting tip. In this case, Eli might carry the memory with him for the rest of his life. This was a fun day in my work. However, I've had the unfortunate experience of seeing homeowners choose companies that don't apply safe work practices that resulted in the workers not getting to go home. This is a serious topic. When you choose to contract with safe work practice tree companies, you indirectly help our communities and our economy become stronger. This is because a tree company with safe work practices can help workers support their family for years to come. A family that can support itself is a huge asset to our economy. Thank you in advance for supporting tree companies that support safe work practices. If you need an arborist that can help you with safe, high canopy tree work, reach out to us on our website for a free consultation. If you're looking for more information on how to care for your trees, subscribe to our channel.